Welcome. It's good to gather and remind each other of God's grace and love that is active in the world today. And this God greets us with these words, "Grace to you and peace, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit." Today we're going to dive into Psalm 10 and the Psalms of Anger, how to read these Psalms of Anger and pray these Psalms of Anger well. And so feel free to open up to Psalm 10 already now. Judy Rauda is going to call us into worship at this time.
Good morning. It's good to be here this morning with you, my church family of Emmanuel, and also those that are visiting with us today. Our call to worship comes to us from Psalm 68, verses 4 through 6, 19 and 20. Sing to God, sing praise to His name. Extol Him who rides on the clouds. His name is the Lord. Rejoice before Him. A father to the fatherless, a defender of widows, is God in His holy dwelling. God sets the lonely in families. He leads forth the prisoners with singing, but the rebellious live in a sun-scorched land. Praise be to the Lord, to God our Savior, who daily bears our burdens. Our God is a God who saves. From the sovereign Lord comes escape from death. Would you please join me in an opening prayer? Oh God, we gather together today to worship you. We come with thirsty hearts praying that your word will satisfy us. We come with aching hearts praying for good news to comfort us. We come with overflowing hearts praying for opportunities to share your love with others. You, O God, know our hearts, you know our thoughts, and you hear our prayers. We ask that through the power of your Holy Spirit, you will help us to understand your voice better as you speak to us through your word, that we may be filled with your goodness and your love. Amen.
Sing your song again, whatever may Congregation of Emmanuel, please join me as I lead you in our congregational prayer. Father, creator of the universe in all its wonder and awe, Jesus, our Redeemer and Advocate for your fallen and broken world, Holy Spirit, Comforter, gifting us with the power to be your disciples, we come in humility before you, our Triune God. In a time of so much uncertainty and confusion, a time when our hearts and minds and our very being feels overwhelmed with doubt and perhaps fear of not knowing what lies ahead. If there are some of your children who are feeling alone or forgotten because they can't feel your nearness in the community we call Emmanuel, Lord, enter into their lives in a way that they may feel your nearness. Quiet our souls. May we feel your presence in the sunrise, the morning song of the birds, the refreshing rainfall, the laughter of a young child, the soft touch of a loved one. Thank you, Father, that you are always near to your children. Thank you that you calm our stormy seas and show us that you are in control even when everything seems out of control. Bless those who are lonely in isolation and keep us aware of our need to be there for those who are suffering depression, who are without jobs, who are physically unwell. Father, we need hope, hope that only you can bring. We pray for an end to this pandemic in our world. We pray for strong and wise leadership in this time of uncertainty. Father, we want to remember the Mose family as they grieve the passing of Alice this past week. Bring them peace and comfort that only your Spirit can offer in a time of this loss. We also ask that you bring relief to those who are suffering in isolation during these past months of lockdown. Those who are feeling little hope as the future seems uncertain for the young and the elderly. Help us be sensitive to the needs of those around us. Give us a renewed hope and grateful hearts for your never-ending blessings that we daily take for granted. Fill our lives with renewed hope, we pray. Pour your blessings onto your children of Emmanuel, those who we have not seen or connected with for several months. Father, in you we put our trust. Bring about your salvation for all your people. We pray in the name of our Redeemer, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.